Okay, students, let us continue.
Spermatogenesis and oogenesis, and you will get a clear cut differences between this. Like, spermatogenesis is the formation of sperms, right? And that happens during puberty stage. So, a male human being will have its own primary sex organs, but the secondary sex organs, like secondary sex organs, that is reproductive life, started from puberty stage. Now puberty is 14 to 18 years of stage, and where testosterone hormone is produced, and under the control of this testosterone hormone, this entire spermatogenesis process starts. So spermatogonia are there, like this is the mother cell, and that is always diploid in chromosome number, and when it undergoes mitosis, repeated mitosis takes place, so it forms number of primary spermatocytes. Then each primary spermatocytes will grow in size, and then it becomes the second meiotic division 1 happen, and that produce secondary spermatocyte. And secondary spermatocyte again undergo meiosis division and form spermatids, and these spermatids are haploid. Remember, one spermatogonium usually leads to 4 spermatids. Okay, so that is the ratio. So 4 spermatids, each of them is haploid in nature. And now these 4 spermatids will convert into spermatozoa. And spermatozoa is having, each one having haploid, and spermatozoa and spermatid, what's the difference? This is a cell. Okay, but this is a structure which is differentiated from that cell. So the process of differentiation here is called as spermiogenesis. And when this spermatozoa is released, and that it is embedded, the head is embedded in the Sertoli cells, and Sertoli cells, you know, they give nourishment. So that is called the process called perspermiation. Okay, now if you come to oogenesis process, but this oogenesis is quite different from spermatogenesis. This oogenesis, that oogonium starts from like fetal life, like when a female child before birth, when it is in mother's womb, the female child in its ovary, in her ovary, it has couple of million this oogonia. But this oogonia, like when she takes birth, then this oogonia remains, like 60 to 80,000 oogonium remains. And then each oogonia, no more oogonia is added after this birth to puberty stage. So 60 to 80,000 oogonia remains, and then in puberty stage, this oogonia then already divided into primary oocyte, and that is arrested in that phase. But in puberty phase, what happens? This primary oocyte undergo meiosis 1 and produce secondary oocyte. And remember, each month the female is producing the secondary oocytes, and these secondary oocyte will turn into ovum when a sperm fuses. So this secondary oocyte is produced, along with that the polar body is also produced, which is degenerated. And ovum, secondary oocyte will turn into ovum when only the sperm fuse, and then adult reproductive life started from this, when it may be fertilized or may not be fertilized. So we will discuss this after you understand this oogenesis process. So now let's go to the next point, that is how this menstrual cycle, what is the cause, what is the pattern of menstrual cycle that goes inside a female, what are the changes that happens? Now here, the first one, there are the 4 phases you have to remember. The first phase is menstruation, second phase is follicular phase, third phase is ovulatory phase, and fourth phase is luteal phase. Now what do you understand by these 4 phases? This is just like a lunar cycle, it is 1 to 28 days. So suppose menstruation lasts for 5 days, that is 1 to 5. Then follicular stage will go to up to 13 days. Then ovulatory phase is 13 to 15 days, and then 15 to that is 16 to 28 days is luteal phase. Now why do we say so? Because it is the changes in the ovary. Now what ovary? How the ovary is changing? So inside the ovary, there is the formation of primary follicle. Then this primary follicle will turn into secondary follicle, and this secondary follicle turns into tertiary follicle, and then it is matured Graafian follicle. It is matured Graafian follicle. So these Graafian follicle having the secondary oocyte. So what is this Graafian follicle contain? This is containing secondary oocyte. Fine. Now this follicular development happens. The like menstruation over 5 days. Now this primary follicle starts formation, secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, and Graafian follicle. This is up to 5 to 13 days. Okay, in a month. Suppose the female is having 1st day to 5th day of the month is menstruation. Then this is the calculation. Now, what is this follicle made up of? This is made up of granulosa cells. So what the depositions are there? Granulosa cells. Even when you see the tertiary follicle, there is a liquid carrying cavity is there, and that is called antrum. Okay, so these are the certain characteristics of follicles. Now this entire synthesis is going because of ovary secrete what hormone? Estrogen. And the cells, these follicles only produce this estrogen hormones. So Graafian follicle is the last stage. And remember, these Graafian follicle undergo ovulation. What is the process called ovulation, which goes in the ovulatory phase? That is 13 to 15 days. It's 3 days ovulation can happen, and there the hormones act like LH and FSH. This is luteinizing hormone and follicular stimulating hormone. The day this surge, LH surge, happens during the ovulatory phase, 13 to 15 days, and then ovulation happens. And ovulation is nothing but Graafian follicle release one secondary oocyte. What they release? Secondary oocyte is released. Now, what happens? This Graafian follicle turns into a phase called corpus luteum. What is that phase called? Corpus luteum. So this Graafian follicle entire turns into corpus luteum, and the phase is called luteal phase. And this corpus luteum is a yellow mass body, and this corpus luteum is the site of secretion of lots of hormone, that is progesterone. So what they produce? The hormone is progesterone. Okay, progesterone is the hormone that is produced by this corpus luteum. So this is luteal phase, which is continued from 16 to 28 days. Now this will not go on. This will somehow, these hormones will come down. This progesterone, estrogen hormone will also show its limitations. And then this secondary oocyte degenerate. And when it is degenerate, it's a waste product. It has to be released out. And in the meantime, the endometrium, that is the uterine wall, also get thickened. And with the blood and follicular cells and mucus, all this get deposited. If fertilization happens, that can give the nourishment to the zygote. But that is also, fertilization does not happen, so the secondary oocyte plus that all the cells, mucus, also get degenerated, and that has to be released out. So the female undergoes menstruation process for 5 days to release all such waste matter. And again in the next month, the cycle is repeated to create a new bed for the nourishment of the embryo. Okay, so this is the oogenesis process. Let's come to now. So what are the hormones that are very, very needed, like LH and FSH hormones needed? LH and FSH hormone is needed. Estrogen and progesterone hormone is needed. Next, we have also understood this corpus luteum. And now fertilization. Now fertilization occurs where? Where does fertilization occur? And here, you see, this is the ovary and this is the infundibulum, and there is the fallopian tube. Now this portion, here is one junction is ampulle and one is isthmic junction. Okay. Now this ampullary isthmic junction, here this fertilization occurs between the ampulla and isthmus. Ampullary isthmic junction, this is fertilization occurs. Now why does fertilization occur? When there is simultaneous
movement
simultaneous movement means both the egg and sperm should reach simultaneously to this ampullary isthmic junction, then only fertilization happens. Okay, and next factor is this is monospermy is allowed, not the polyspermy. So that means monospermy means single sperm will fuse with single secondary oocyte. Okay, so if this is the oocyte, then only single sperm that reach faster and that reach the first will go for this. When it penetrates this wall get under cortical reaction, and this cortical reaction is what it gets stiff, it get stiff, and no more sperm will be added to it. So polyspermy will be prevented, there will be no polyspermy because of this cortical reaction. So this wall get stiff, so polyspermy is not. Now this sperm when penetrate, then this ovum, the secondary oocyte undergo the changes of becoming ovum, and then this is the fusion of this nucleus. Inside this nucleus is there DNA will be entering, and then DNA of secondary oocyte, this gets fused, and the process is called as amphimixis. The process is called as amphimixis, that is the fusion of male and female prone nucleus is called amphimixis. Now this arranged, and this after amphimixis fertilization is over, and you are going to get zygote. What are you going to get? Zygote. Clear? Next, this is about fertilization. Now what are the egg structure? Like egg is the simple common term, but if you give to egg then or ovum, then you will get a round color that is quite having lots of cytoplasm, the nutrition, and there is a nucleus is there, and a perivital and space is there, and then there is zona, pellucida layer, and then there are lots of cell structures are there, you can see in the figure given in the NCRT. Then this is these are the corona radiata. So that means the sperm has to release the enzymes. Penetrate this path, and then the sperm can release its nucleus into it. So that means it has to produce, the acrosome of sperm must produce sperm lysine, isn't it? And the sperm lysine contains lots of enzymes like corona penetrating enzyme, zona penetrating enzyme, and then that is hyaluronidase. So these enzymes will help in penetration of the sperm, only the nucleus part into this ovum, and then only this fertilization can happen. Clear? So the process of fusion of the sperm in with the ovum is called fertilization, and during fertilization a sperm comes in contact with the zona pellucida layer of the ovum, and then induces changes in the membrane that blocks the entry of additional sperms. It ensures only one sperm to fertilize, and the secretion of the acrosome help in the sperm enter into the cytoplasm of the ovum through the zona pellucida and the plasma membrane. So after this zygote is produced, then we will discuss about this cleavage. Now what is this cleavage? So here after the zygote is fertilized, that is zygote is produced after fertilization, then the process starts cleavage. And this, what is cleavage? The cleavage is nothing but repeated mitosis. So cleavage is nothing but this mitosis, and that is also a separate pattern is there, like production of cells, anticlinal and periclinal ways are there by which the cells are produced, and then this will become the stage like morula. So when it is become 8 cell stage, and we say it is morula. When it becomes 32 cell stage, we say it is blastula. Okay, 32 cell stage, and this is 8 cell stage, and then it becomes gastrula, which is 64 cell stage. So like this morula, blastula, gastrula stages are there, and then the 3 germ layer will produce, that is ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, and after this, this organ differentiations will be there, organs will be developed, and then a fetus is developed, that is a rudimentary baby that is non-functional organs, but baby having all the structure, but that is all non-functional. And then after fetus, it's developed into a like embryonic development will be there. Okay, development will be there, and then it becomes a baby, right? And then baby will be undergoing parturition. So what is that phase called? Parturition, that is the delivery of the baby. So this is the way how it goes on. So post-fertilization event. So this starts from all these links are post-fertilization event, and this blastula is very very important because this helps in implantation process. Okay, and this gastrula phase, you know, here the differentiation occurs. So differentiation three germ layers, that is ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. So it is said that before blastula stage, one can make the clones, but are not after that. Now, this organ differentiation occurs, you know, this germ layers, and that takes, you know, 9 months for this development, and this 9 months is, that is called your gestation period. What is the process called? Gestation period, that is the development of the baby inside the mother's womb, and there is the formation of one more special kind of tissue called placenta. The placenta, you know already, that provides nourishment, isn't it? So that provides gases. Placenta facilitated the supply of oxygen, nutrients to the embryo, removal of carbon dioxide, excretory waste matter produced by the embryo. Placenta is connected to the embryo through the umbilical cord, which helps in the transport of substances to and from the embryo. Placenta acts as an endocrine tissue and produces several hormones like HCG, HPL, estrogen, progesterone. So this is multiple times they increase, and this always produced in women only during pregnancy, remember these hormones. And ovary itself produces a relaxing hormone. Then another, when parturition occur, after implantation, then when baby development is over for 9 months, then this parturition occur after fetal ejection reflex. Okay, now fetal ejection reflex is what? It is induced by complex neuroendocrine mechanism. Parturition originates from the fully developed fetus, and the placenta induce mild uterine contraction called fetal ejection reflex. So that's why the uterine muscle causes stronger uterine contraction, which is turned to stimulate further secretion of oxytocin. Now uterine contraction, oxytocin secretion continues till stronger and stronger contraction, and that leads to the baby out of the uterus. And that is using the birth canal, that is called parturition. And after parturition, obviously the mother should be ready with the feeding, that is, it starts lactation. And this lactation means the first milk which comes out from the mother's body is colostrum. And the colostrum is rich in nutrition, even it provides passive immunity. Passive immunity is provided. So what is provided by colostrum? It's a very important thing that provides passive immunity. IgA, immunoglobulin A, is provided by this passive immunity. Is it? Okay. Now this completes the entire pre-fertilization, fertilization, and post-fertilization events of this female human sexual reproduction. Okay, human reproduction. So just go through the entire chapter. Ask me your doubts in the online class. Thank you.